I told you one too many times. You smile like I'm undone, but maybe you'd rather me undo those crimes. Summer nights walking back to your house, watching you dance when there wasn't a sound. Really felt like we figured it out, what I'd give to get back there now.
Today we are at the last day of the JCPenney in Fort Collins, Colorado. My name is Optopolis. Welcome back to the channel where we explore where no one else has explored before. We're gonna go ahead and see what is left inside of this closing JCPenney right behind me. It's my arguably second childhood store and definitely one of my favorites. So let's document it for the last time while it's open. All right, here it is. Let's go ahead and go in and see what is left. As you can see, last day, it's here. Like they have a lot of carts. Even a King Supers one lurking. There is definitely not much left. It's pretty much it right there. I love how all the JCPenneys tend to have this wall mural thing going on. Right over here was where all the clothing was, like pants, jeans, and most of these fixtures have even been sold. I can't believe how empty this store is now. It's very barren. This one always kind of seemed quite luxurious. For lack of a better word, it was a really nice store overall. Right over here was where all the shoes and underwear stuff was. Like the restrooms are still open, but of course with the virus, you don't do the drinking fountains. Pretty sure that right here was where all the bedding was. Pretty sparse. Obviously, you can tell that's where all the towels and all that stuff was. Right here, what looks like was where all the kitchen stuff was, and that's gone too. Well, here's where the salon and portrait studio were. Not anymore. There's the design section. And of course in this area they have all the good old mannequins. I can't remember the exact spot or angle, but I know this area right over here that is on the back left of the store was where all the kids' stuff was. I remember coming here a lot for things like coats and all sorts of stuff like that, but now it's just fixtures. It's honestly just sad to see this place go. I don't know why they chose this one, but clearly they had some reason. Woof, they just knocked down the whole tent that was around Sephora and they're cleaning it up. Dang, too bad. Too bad. It does kind of suck to lose this place because of how many memories I have here. I overlocked this store more than mine in Cheyenne, which is smaller. Some thrills. There was Sephora, but sucks like heck to to lease this place is, sucks like heck. Really does. Even all the furniture over the fitting rooms is for sale. Interesting sign there. It almost would appear that the stakes used to lift clothes off the racks are even getting sold off. I always will like the vibe that these doors gave off, and it looks like even the jewelry area is getting pretty emptied out. Much bigger than Cheyenne, that's for sure. Is where the pricing is. I love the chandeliers. That's cool. I remember many times there were benches here in this doorway, and we'd often sit here after we got done looking at whatever we were gonna look at. Always fun time.